Emma Husar is tired of being mad. She wants money from the Labour Party that she says destroyed her health and her career.
There are two things that I do know, Hugh. The only things that ever change anything in this country is pressure and the hip pocket.
The former MP from Sydney's West was accused of repeatedly exposing herself to Labour frontbencher Jason Clare. He denied it. The claim came from a former staffer.
He was making those allegations in an act of revenge because he'd been fired.
The so-called Sharon Stone incident was then leaked to BuzzFeed, she says, from someone inside the Labour Party.
This is the part where we see the ALP's absolute corrupt behaviour, where they made me resign before the findings were handed down.
Husar now says she was blackmailed, told if she didn't go, an internal party investigation into staffing issues would be made much worse.
Absolutely, that's a form of blackmail.
Is it legal?
Blackmail's not legal under the law.
An internal inquiry exonerated her of sexualised behaviour and misuse of funds, but Emma Husar says the public smear was enough. She now argues it was sexual harassment enabled by Labour and utterly destructive to her professional career.
I haven't worked for 2.5 years. I haven't worked since the last day of Parliament.
It also destroyed her health. She has moved to Perth to recover.
My hair fell out, so I would take a shower and just sort of run my hands through my hair and there would just be handfuls of hair just falling out.
The former staffer has declined to speak to us on the record, and it's a no comment today from Anthony Albanese, though the Labor leader has previously argued there are other sides to the story.
I regret that Emma Husar feels aggrieved, but I also regret that more than a dozen of her former staff in the one term in which she served in Parliament also feel aggrieved.
Emma Husar maintains that is untrue.
As it stands today, 3 years on, I've only ever had one name and one list of complaints from one complainant.
Emma Husar says she's been motivated to resume the fight by the response to Brittany Higgins' alleged rape in Parliament. But she questions whether there will be lasting change.
So what is your message now to a young woman looking to pursue a parliamentary career on either side of politics?
Don't do it.
Hugh Rimmington for 10 News First.